All right, so that's all the algorithms that we're going to talk about in terms of unsupervised clustering algorithms. But I would like to kind of pop up a level and talk a little bit about different properties that clustering algorithms might have, desirable properties. So the three that I'm going to talk about are richness, scale invariance, and consistency. And these are good things to have, right? I'd like to be rich and consistent.
And Lord knows you'd like to be scale invariant.
I wish I were scale invariant. I guess it would be very hard for me to gain weight if that were true.
Mm-hmm. No matter what the scale is, the number's always the same.
All right. So if you have a clustering algorithm, what does it do? It takes a set of distances, D, and maps them to a set of clusters.
Or partitions.
Right. Or a partition. Right. And these are three properties of those kinds of mappings. So richness is the idea that for any assignment of objects to the clusters, there's some distance matrix that would cause your clustering algorithm to produce that clustering. For any clustering that you want to achieve, there is some distance matrix where P of D, your clustering algorithm, your clustering scheme, produces that clustering.
So that's like saying all inputs are valid and all outputs are valid.
All inputs, which is to say the distance matrices, sure, those are valid, and anything could be an output. Any way of clustering could be an output. Because, you know, think of the alternative. The alternative is there are certain clusters that you just can't produce, and that seems wrong, doesn't it? It ought to be the case that your clustering algorithm should produce whatever is appropriate and shouldn't be limited in what it can express.
Sometimes you even want your algorithm to say, you know what, there's only one cluster here.
Yeah, I mean, totally. If I showed you a picture, you might look at it, and you'd say, I just see one cluster, and it looks like a clown. The second property that we're talking about is scale invariance, and this is, I think, much more straightforward, at least in terms of conceptually. So it just means that if I give you a distance matrix and I double all the distances or halve all the distances, it shouldn't change what the clustering is, that the clustering algorithm should be invariant to what the space of the points is, assuming that we keep the relative distances the same.
So this is the NASA problem. So this says that if I come up with a bunch of clusterings because I've been measuring points in miles, if I suddenly start measuring them in kilometers, it shouldn't change anything.
That's right. Yeah, change of units. Yeah, that's a really good way of thinking about it. It's not even that I'm scaling the distances. I'm just using inches instead of feet. It should be the case that it's still the same data. All right, and then the last one is maybe the hardest one to visualize, but it's a really reasonable thing, and you would expect clustering to act this way. So consistency says that if we have some clustering, if your clustering algorithm produces some clusters, so let's do a little example of that, then shrinking the intra-cluster distances and expanding the inter-cluster distances does not change the clustering. Let me show you that. All right, and now I've edited this so that within the clusters, the points have gotten closer together, more so in this one than the other. Or not changing them at all. But in this particular case, I shrunk this one a lot, I shrunk this one a little, and then I moved the clusters a little bit farther apart. This changes the distances a bit, and we'd like our clustering algorithm to continue to consider these clusters, right? It shouldn't introduce new clusters because we've shrunken things, and it shouldn't want to join these things together because they've gotten further apart. So that's this notion of consistency. And a little bit more cumbersome to describe, but very natural thing to think about in the clustering setting.
Well, that makes sense, right? So this is where our domain knowledge comes in. So distances are a measure of similarity, right?
Yep.
So what consistency says, if you found that a bunch of things were similar and a bunch of other things were dissimilar, then if you made the things that were similar more similar and the things that were not similar less similar, it shouldn't change your notion of which things are similar and which things are not.
Yeah, which things are alike, which things want to be grouped together. Yeah, right. Uh-huh. Good. So you think you understand these three clustering ideas?
I believe I do.
All right, so let's put them into play a little bit.
Okay.